So today we are going to show you how to build sticky Elementor headers starting from the basics. Then we'll cover the scroll color change, the transparent sticky headers, Glassmorhpism and blurry effect as well, how to hide the menu when scrolling upwards, then a shrink effect, how to change the logo color, and also how to change the logo on hover mode. Well, hello, my name is Dave from the Plus Addons from Elementor, and today we are going to explore 8 unique Elementor header effects with no code required. Now, don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel as we upload 2 new Elementor videos each week, which will make you an Elementor master in no time. And also, feel free to share this with your Facebook communities so that your friends can learn more about Elementor as well. Now let's have a look at all the essential plugins for this project. And the first 2 plugins that we need are the Plus Addons for Elementor and also the Plus Addons for Elementor Pro version. Now clearly we need a page builder, which is Elementor. Now we can build this header using 2 different options. You can either enable and install Elementor Pro, in which case you can go into templates and use the theme builder, or you can install Nexter theme. At the moment we are using the Pro version, which comes with the Nexter builder, or you can use the free version, which will allow you to create the exact same project as we are working on today. And for this, all you have to do is to go into Appearance, in the Theme section, Add New, in the search bar, look for Nexter, and this is the very one here, okay? So just install it. As I said, the free version will work absolutely fine as well. Very good, so now we are going to cover each style step by step, and feel free to skip to any chapter to learn your favorite style. And we'll start with Sticky Elementor Header Basic. Okay, very good, so let's get started. So first we need to create our header. So this is a new template that we need to create. Again, there are 2 options to do so. You can use Elementor Pro and the Theme Builder, but for this demo, we're going to use the Nexter theme, and part of Nexter theme, you have the Nexter builder, as you can see of all our templates here. And all you have to do is just to add a new one, and let's give it a title, so maybe header template, and just underneath, we have our layout options here. So this is a section. What type of a section? This is a header, okay? And just underneath, we need to include this. So where are we going to display this? Well, basically on the entire website, just like this. And now we can publish, and then edit with Elementor. Very good, so let's create our structure. So let's go with the 3 columns. So on the left-hand side, we'll have our menu, so we can maybe reduce that to 12%. Maybe in the middle, we'll have our main menu sections, maybe 55%, and whatever's left for the call to action, maybe 2 or 3 different call to action. So let's get started. So from here, we're going to look for our first item, which is the site logo. As you can see, this is part of the Plus add-on as well. So I'm going to drag and drop this here. And then we can insert our image. So all we have to do is to click on this. I uploaded already a few, so we're just going to use Nike for now, just like this with the swoosh, okay? And now right here in the middle, we're going to insert our navigation menu. So we're going to search for the widget, navigation. So there it is. This is from the Plus add-on. This is the Pro version. So we're going to insert this one right here in the middle. And now we need to select the menu we want to display. So let's select our main navigation. Very good. And on the right-hand side, we're going to add our multiple call to action. And for this, we're going to use the header meta content, which is a very practical widget, as I'm going to show you now. So basically here in the meta content, you can add as many items as you want, call to actions, etc., etc. So as you can see, we have search. So let's add another one. Perhaps you can add a mini card, an extra toggle bar, a language switcher, music, and call to action buttons, obviously, no, as well. So let's add, for example, a mini card as well. And a third item, perhaps we're going to add a call to action button. And now we need to enable our display features. So from this, we scroll down a little bit. We have the search option. As you can see, we can enable this. Now it's displaying here. Perfect. And you can choose among different styles. It's really up to you. We have our card option. Again, we enable this. So it's displaying now. And you can again select among different styles. And let's add an icon, for instance. Okay, we can look for a custom icon. So there you go. A shopping cart like this is just about perfect. And next, we have our call to action. So let's enable this as well. At the moment, it says button one. So let's maybe rename this call, for instance. Okay. And then you can add the link to redirect to a certain page as well. And of course, to make it even more obvious what it is for, you can change the icon as well. So let's look for something related to phone. There you go. We have one here, so we can change this as well. And now it is more user friendly, obviously, you know. And then next we could add maybe a little bit of spacing in between those to add a bit of breathing space. And we're going to extra options. We unlink this and we're going to add a bit of spacing maybe on the left hand side. Maybe let's try 30 pixels. There you go. That's perfect. And we can align this to the right, just like this. So there you go, guys. That's just done for the header section. This is our main template. And now we can go and create our page. So let's go back to our WordPress dashboard. And this time we're going to go to our pages and then we're going to create a new one. So let's add a new page. Let's give it a title. So maybe 8 unique Elementor header styles. We're going to publish, publish again. And now let's edit with Elementor. Very good. So now let's add a little bit of content to our page. So from here, let me show you a very cool feature that's unique to the Plus add-ons for Elementor. Basically, if you go to our website here, let's go to any of those sample websites. So maybe designer. And as you can see, we have a bit of content here, a hero section, etc. What we can do is to have a cross-domain copy and paste feature. So all we have to do basically is to click on this button here that says copy. Now, if we go back to our own Elementor page, we can create a section. If you right-click on it, now you have the plus paste. Click on this. And as you can see, in just a matter of few clicks, we have our demo content recreated on our Elementor page. And feel free to do so with as many sections from the demo website as you wish. And now let's take care of our sticky Elementor header effect and let's start with the basics. So basically, if you click on your menu section here, we go into extra options. And from here, we have a toggle switch next to sticky menu, so you can just enable it and now it will be sticky. So let's update. Now, bear in mind that every changes that you make here in the backend will only reflect in the frontend. So you won't be able to preview this in the backend. So this is why we need a frontend page as well. And as you can see, this is our menu. And now if we scroll down the page, our menu is now sticky. But as you can see, there's an overlay issue. There's a bit of text behind. So this is not really visible, which brings us to option number two. Now, let me show you the sticky menu with on-scroll color change effect. Okay, so let's go back here. And what we can do now is to add a background color to our menu. So what we can do is go into style. We're going to go into sticky main menu. And as you can see, if we scroll down the options here, we have the sticky option. And right here, we can add a background color. So let's select a color for this. So let's add maybe some dark blue or something like this. Okay, very good. And then let's do the same in normal mode. So let's enable the background color and let's select maybe a bright gray, something like this. Okay, so let's update and let's put this to the test. So let's go back to our homepage here and let's refresh. There you go. As you can see, we have a gray background here. And if you scroll down the page, it will change color. And now we have a dark blue. And as you can see, clearly our font is not visible here. There is no contrast. So how can we change this? And for this, we're going to go back to our Elementor page and scroll back up our options here. And as you can see, we have the normal, hover and active mode. And here we can select the color. So let's change the color here to white and the same for normal icon color. So let's select white again. Now we can update and then we can have a quick look at our front end. As you can see, this is a dark gray on bright gray. And now if we scroll down the page, as you can see, now we have dark blue with white font on top. So as you can see at the moment, our background is a solid color background. So maybe perhaps you want to add a transparent background and still reveal a little bit of the content of your page. So how can we do this? So if you go back here in your normal mode and sticky mode, you can change the color. So you click on this now. As you can see, we have that feature here. You can slide right to left. And as you can see, the farther left you go, the clearer it is. It's fully transparent to fully opaque. So you can select any value you want in between this. So let's go ahead maybe with this shade here, maybe around 80%. And let's update. And now we can go back to our front end. And if we scroll down the page, as you can see, we can still see a little bit of the background, but the contrast is well in place, as you can see. So this is easily readable, no problem at all for your visitors. Okay, so next, let me show you our next feature, which is Glassmorhpism or Blurry Background, which is a very popular feature at the moment. So let's go back to the Plus Addons website and let me show you the extra section here. We have Glassmorhpism, which is a free widget, by the way. And with this, you can add premium effect, glass effect, frosted effect to your different elements on your page. So this would work, for instance, with info boxes, carousels, pricing tables, etc., etc. So again, it's a very powerful feature. So let's go back to our page here and let's add this effect to our own menu section here. And for this, all we have to do is to use the backdrop filter here. So let's click on the pencil. And as you can see, we can add a blur value. So let's add maybe a value of 15 or something like this. You know, now we can update. And then let's go back to our homepage. And if we scroll down the page now, you will see we have a very premium effect where we can still see the background, but it is now blurry. So there is no interference at all. It's very easy to read. We can see everything in our menu section. So this is for Glassmorhpism. And next is our hide header on scroll down effect. So as you can see at the moment, if I scroll down or up the page, our menu section, our sticky menu will always be there. So this is a very powerful feature. Now when we scroll down the page, it will not display. So let me show you how we can achieve this. So let's go back to our Elementor page. And from here, we go back to our content here. And as you can see, we have the extra options. And we have a second one here, on mouse, scroll up, sticky. So we need to enable this now. So let's click update. And now let's go back to our front end. So we refresh our page. So let's scroll down the page. As you can see, it is not showing. But if I scroll back up our page, it will show, it will reveal the sticky menu. So this is how it works. Again, this is a very powerful feature because it adds value to your visitors and it makes the user experience much better as well. And next we have our shrinking effect, which is another very popular one. So for this, let's go back to our Elementor page. So let's disable this one for now. And let's go into style. So for our main menu, so this one that's not sticky, I'm going to add some padding on top and bottom. So I'm going to add maybe 30 and again 30 here. Okay, so you can see there's a bit of spacing all around it. Now let's center our three elements in the middle, because at the moment, as you can see, the logo is on top. This menu is in the middle. This one is on top as well. So for this, we're going to click on the column here. And here the vertical align, we're going to select middle. As you can see, nice, perfectly centered with the other one. And we do the same with this section here in the middle. So that looks perfect now. And now let's address the settings of our sticky menu. So we go back to our navigation menu right here. Instead of menu, we go into sticky main menu. And this time we're going to address the inner padding. So instead of 30, we're going to leave it 10 and 10. And as you can see, now we'll reduce from 30 to 10. So let's put this to the test. So let's click on update. Let's go back to our homepage. As you can see, plenty of breathing space all around it. Now if we scroll down the page, as you can see, the size has been reduced. So this is how you can shrink your menu section. Now let's address our next effect. So as you can see at the moment, our logo looks absolutely fine on a bright background. But if I scroll down the page, it doesn't stand out at all on the darker background. So how can you change the color of the logo as you scroll down and display a sticky header? So for this, we go back to our Elementor page here. We click on our logo itself. And from here, we're going to click on extra options. And as you can see, we have the option to enable the sticky logo. So click on this. And now we can upload our second version of our logo. So if you click on this, as you can see, I already uploaded the white version. So ideally, you'd like to use a PNG file with a clear background. So we can insert our media now. And as you can see, you also have the option to reduce the size of our logo, which means that if you resize your header, you can also resize your logo. So as you can see here, maybe we're going to select 80% in sticky mode. And now let's update and let's put this to the test. So we go back to our homepage here. So as you can see, now we have a black logo on a gray background. If we scroll down the page, now we have a white logo on a blue background. And also the size of our logo has been reduced to 80%. As you can see, now we have 80%. If we scroll back up, we have the full size 100%. And finally, last but not least, I'm going to show you a very nice effect, how you can change your logo on hover mode. So if we go to the Plus Addons website, I'm going to show you what it looks like. So at the moment, we have a 5 icon. So if I hover on top, it will reveal the full size logo. So now I'm going to show you how you can do this on your own website. So let's go back to our Elementor page. And from here, we're going to go to Site Logo. And this time, instead of normal, we're going to select double. And as you can see, now we can add a second logo. So let's do this. So let's click on this. I already uploaded the full size Nike logo. So let's insert. And now if we update, if you go back to our homepage now, and let's have a quick look. As you can see, we have the swoosh logo. If I hover on top, it will reveal the full size Nike logo. All right, so that's not all. There is so much more that you can do with the Plus Addons for Elementor. For instance, you can also build some horizontal mega menu like this one here, so you can insert all sorts of items. And as you can see, it looks very, very professional indeed. Or vertical menu like this one as well. As you can see, absolutely fantastic. And you can tweak every aspect of it as well. And you can also create some mobile menus and tweak literally everything you want and have an off-canvas menu showing up as well. So these are dedicated menus for mobiles only, which will give your visitors a superb user experience. Now we are open to your suggestions, and if your favorite feature is missing, then feel free to add it to our roadmap so that we can hear your great ideas. Again, if you liked and learned something new in this video, then feel free to share with your friends in your Facebook communities. And make sure to hit the like and subscribe button so that YouTube knows that you loved this video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you guys in the next video.